I was invited to the Shearer Candles flagship store, and it's because it was International Fragrance Week, and they invited some of us to come and learn about the fragrances, test our knowledge of fragrances, and also pour our own candles. So if you watch the channel, you'll know that I love Shearer Candles. And on the night, they had so much for us to do to test out the different knowledges that we have on the zones of fragrance, if we knew our musks from our florals, our fruities from our spices. And I can tell you it's harder than you think. And also just to check out exactly how a brand gets to be in their position where they are a heritage brand and yet they continuously move forward. Amber Noir, as you can see there, that really is the leading most popular fragrance. That's the one that consistently outsells all others, and it's their staple fragrance. Now, we actually got to pour our own Amber Noir on the evening, and by pouring our own, it was slightly modified to how they would do it in reality. They gave us a little candle to put in the middle for our wick purposes, but it was great fun because you don't realise exactly the elements that go in to building a candle. As you can see here, a little bit of the scented wax just to hold your smaller candle in. In reality, that's not how they do it, but for us, it's a nice easy way to do it. Candle stays in place, pour in your hot wax, and then let it cool. Now, what's interesting here too is this is black wax, and that's really hard to do. Shearer do black wax, but if you actually look on the high street, you don't see black wax very often. You really don't, and that's because it's very hard to do. And you can see the raw candle wax in its rawest form before it's melted. But again, just from a different angle, tiny little bit of the oil, and believe me, the aroma was already filling the shop. It was lovely. Pop your little candle in and it will stick to the candle wax, and you make sure it's in the middle and that the wick is nice and straight. And then you pour in your hot wax to cover the candle up to the wick, just maybe a couple of centimetres from the top. And then within 15 to 20 minutes, it's pretty much set. Now, we did our fragrance quiz where you had samples of fragrance and you were asked to work out what the fragrance was or what it reminded you of. Wow, that was hard. See, once you can't see it, it's actually really difficult to tell what it is. I did okay, but I thought I would do better. And then just to finish, we had a Q&A and we learned so much about the brand. They've even got their own Amazon advert at the moment, the only company in Scotland, possibly even the UK, with their own Amazon advert, because they are such a heritage brand that are constantly moving forward. But overall, it really opened my eyes to how some great independents are really out there doing it, but also just, you know, what you can actually do with your skills and with your knowledge to really push forward your ideas. And if you get a chance, check out the website, because they're constantly evolving the new fragrances. And every time you smell one, you think, right, that's another one that I need to add to my list. So I really enjoyed pouring my own candle. I hope you enjoyed watching my little video, and I'll see you again soon.